terrible. Absolutely terrible.
My thoughts are with him, with the family.
It's very sad, very sad.
It's the terrifying big C word no one wants to hear.
Breaking news from Buckingham Palace, which has announced that the King has been diagnosed with cancer.
Today's shock revelation leaving the UK and the world reeling.
I'm sure he'll fight it like anyone else would, but it's a horrible shock.
I pray that he will recovery.
He's got to have the best doctors. He's got the best chance. Age against him. Rest up, boy.
Today, the thoughts of all Australians are with King Charles and his family. We wish him very much a speedy recovery.
Buckingham Palace has confirmed the diagnosis was made during Charles's recent hospital procedure for a benign enlarged prostate.
How are you feeling? How are you feeling?
The type of cancer has not yet been revealed, only that it's not prostate cancer. The King's prognosis is, for now, unclear.
His Majesty has today commenced a schedule of regular treatments, during which time he has been advised by doctors to postpone public-facing duties.
Releasing this information is helpful. Speculation is dangerous. Sometimes speculation can be corrosive.
Prince Harry is rushing home to be by his dad's side.
I think that tells you not only the seriousness of the situation, but, you know, will open the door to conversations of, you know, an olive branch from Harry to his father or vice versa.
Charles will take a break from public events, but will remain in his role as head of state, with Prince William expected to step up in his absence.
The function of government requires the King to play his part, approving an enormous number of documents and giving effect to various different instruments from government. What he can't do is go on all these planned trips around the Commonwealth and to the other realm.
So after a decades-long wait to ascend the throne, what does this diagnosis mean for the King and the monarchy?
Royal commentator Victoria Arbiter has been following this story. Victoria, the palace, they didn't reveal what type of cancer the King has been diagnosed with. Do you think that's a bad sign?
All they've told us is that it's not prostate cancer, so it is a little bit up in the air in terms of what his exact diagnosis is, but I think the palace is going to be keen to get all their ducks in a row before they reveal too much information. I think this is where the palace is going to be walking a very fine line and juggling a bit of a balancing act because, on the one hand, they want to be transparent while also respecting the King's right to privacy, but they also have to consider that they're providing adequate information that is then going to kind of calm the storm, because if you say it's X type of cancer, then suddenly everybody online is talking about what the prognosis might be, how long he might have, how advanced it is. So you can see why it starts to become quite complicated in terms of how to navigate this story.
We had hoped to see King Charles and Camilla visit Australia later this year. What does this diagnosis mean for that trip?
Well, we're still very much hoping that they will be able to be there. That trip was supposed to be on the heels of the Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting, which is taking place in October in Samoa. October is still a bit of a ways off, so much is going to depend on what type of treatment he's having and how he's feeling following the treatment. He turned 75 last November, so he is of a certain age, but at the same time, he's very fit. Generally speaking, he eats well. So here's hoping that Australia and New Zealand will still be very much on the cards come October.
Victoria, I think the first thing I thought about was how close this is to the death of the late Queen. Just that it was so suddenly upon us again, this sort of situation. I know you're not in the UK now, unless London's landmarks have changed considerably very recently, but I imagine you're in touch with people in the UK. How are they coping with the closeness of these two things?
I think you just hit the nail on the head, and for that very reason, I think a lot of people have found this news quite unsettling. There has been an absolutely tremendous outpouring on social media, and I think the chief reason is exactly what you say, is because it is still so close, really, to when the late Queen passed away. It hasn't even been a year since the King's coronation. So I think people are concerned, but I also think this is in part, you know, behind palace walls, things are also always very carefully choreographed. And on Sunday, the King was photographed attending church at Sandringham. They knew that this news was going to be revealed on Monday, and so I think part of seeing him out and about at church was to reassure the public. So I think people are very concerned. Some have found it a little rattling. But again, I think with all the well wishes of the nation behind him, hopefully he will be back in fine form very, very soon.
Well, the knock-on effects of this are, of course, yet to be seen. But my mind goes to Harry. There's such a strained relationship between Harry and the rest of the family. And could this be a chance to mend the rift?
I certainly think a lot of people are hoping that's going to be the case. Now, the King has been very clear throughout the turmoil of the last 3 years that his door is always open. He's long talked about his darling boy and he adores his son. Having said that, they haven't talked in quite a long time beyond the King calling to let Harry know of his diagnosis. We know there was a conversation. But prior to that, Harry hadn't seen his father since the coronation, and even then it was very brief. So they haven't had any kind of quality face-to-face time together in a significant amount of time. Now, I think Harry is to be commended for saying that he's going to be getting on a plane and going straight home because it is the right thing to do, and it's important that he be there to support his father. My hope is that his focus will remain on the King's well-being, on supporting his father, and not on the grievances that have been concerning him since he left the royal family.
Sickness really shapes priorities, doesn't it? Victoria, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much.